Howdy all, this is Shane and welcome to the In The Blues mailbag. This is coming to you from Florida still. I'm still overseas. I have 2 weeks to go before I head home to wintertime, which I'm not looking forward to. It's going to be horrible. This time, I'm just sort of going to mix it up. I'm going to show you a little bit about what I've been doing, piece together some video footage so you can see what's been happening. Being that I'm away, I'm not always online, but I have been getting a lot of questions coming in, and I mean lots and lots. I probably had 1,000 comments easily since I've been away. And it's one of those things, I've been catching up on a lot of them lately, but it's also been kind of hard. A lot of the stuff that I've been answering is on my Facebook page while I'm traveling. It's just so much easier to maintain. So that's at facebook.com/intheblues. There's already like 2,000 people on there and it's been going really well. A lot of the Facebook guys and girls know exactly what I've been up to. I've been at Jerry's Lefty Guitars in Sarasota, Florida, which was part of the idea of coming over. And it's been fantastic. I got to play some of the best guitars, and two of which I'd never heard of before, either through my own ignorance or the fact that I've just never seen them anywhere before. Two German guitars, actually. One's called a Nick Huber, which, wow, it's probably the nicest sounding Telecaster type guitar I've ever played. And it felt fantastic. They also make some really high gloss, beautiful looking guitars that just really set the standard. And also the Duesenberg guitar, which has done my head in completely. I'm not a fan usually of guitars that have lots of bling or, you know, stuff on them. I just like very simple sort of styles in guitars, like the Tellies and Strats and ES-335s. But the Duesenberg guitar is fantastic. And yeah, I think I'm gonna buy one of those at some point. It's very, very cool. I mean, it has a P90 in the neck, a humbucker in the bridge, but they're the best sounding single coil and humbucker that I've played. And I got to play lots and lots of guitars at Jerry's. I played Paul Reed Smith's, I played Sir guitars, which I nearly took home. I got to play Gene L guitars, I got to play Anderson's, I got to play Collings guitar. I also got to play a 1960s Gibson. I got to play a 70s Fender Stratocaster. I got to play lots and lots of great stuff. And to my ear and hand, the Duesenberg and Nick Huber guitars are amazing. They're the best that I've ever played, and it's sort of done my head in a little bit. You know what? The Sur guitars were exceptionally good. I think the Sur guitar, the antique classic Telecaster style one, totally wipes the floor with my 52 reissue. It just absolutely does. It sounds great. It feels fantastic. The neck's amazing. Everything about that guitar is great. So I sort of was in a bit of a dilemma where I didn't know if I'd buy one or what I'd get. And then by the time I was done, I probably filmed 30 videos and yeah, now I'm all confused. So we'll see what happens in the long term. I think when I get home, I'll make a decision on what to buy. I may move some stuff just to get the Duesenberg guitar home. I think that's the one I'm gonna get. I'm not sure if I'm just gonna go the whole hog and get the one that looks like the Corvette or the, you know, that kind of car style one with the blue, or whether or not I'm just gonna go get the black one, which is a little bit more simple with the anodized gold sort of pickguard. And yeah, they're both the same. They just, you know, it's a different look. I may get the blue one. I have a feeling that was the one that really spoke to me the most, but I played so much great stuff and Jerry was an awesome guy. I've got an interview coming up that I've just shot with him as well. That'll be posted on YouTube before any of the actual guitar demos start. I'm on a little laptop, or the big laptop, whatever you want to call it here, and it has trouble sort of rendering videos down. So to do this, my laptop will probably shut off a couple of times trying to actually render the video. So we'll see how we go with it. I also did a massive road trip. I went through a lot of the southern states, including Florida, Georgia, Mississippi, Alabama, New Orleans. I went to all of them. And yeah, it was really cool. That was over about 10 days. And we got to see lots of great stuff, including the swamps, the beaches, you know, lots and lots of great stuff, including cities and, you know, whatever else. Just the coastline's really beautiful. So I had no expectations of Alabama. I've just, you know, it's one of those places that I think the world doesn't know anything about, including myself. And when I went there, it was fantastic. I gotta say that coastline there is some of the best stuff I've ever seen. And coming from Australia, that's a big call. But yeah, there's some definitely some beautiful places along there. And I'm just gonna show some footage as I talk, as you can probably tell. So there's going to be lots of little snippets coming up on screen so you can check it out. Yeah, New Orleans was a lot of fun. I got to see the swamps like I mentioned and get to see the gators and all that in their sort of natural habitat was really cool. And yeah, I really enjoyed more so the swamps than the city of New Orleans. I didn't really sort of feel that comfortable in New Orleans, as probably as some people who live there might. I don't know, it just felt a bit funny for me. It's probably changed a lot over the years, I'm not too sure. But I mean, in general, it was a good town. The downtown area wasn't really what I was expecting. I was a little disappointed, but I got to see John Cleary play live, who's an English guy, piano player, fantastic vocalist, great singer. I got to see him at a bar there and it was awesome. So yeah, I'm glad I got to do that, and just to sort of hear one of their, even though he's an Englishman, I get to hear one of their best, musicians of the area. So it was really, really cool. And on my next trip, I'd definitely love to see more of the South again and maybe go through past Texas as well, and just maybe do an East to West Coast drive or something like that. We'll see how we go. So some of you are probably wondering what I've picked up. If you're not on my Facebook page, you probably aren't privy to some of the information, although I did post a video about a guitar recently. But so far, this pedal here is totally rocking. This is the Soul Food Electro-Harmonix pedal. And I got a chance to use this over the course of a few days at Jerry's on the new videos, as well as his Timmy pedal, which was fantastic. And I recently demoed a clone or a clone zombie or whatever it was called. This, definitely get this. This is a really good buy, and I don't know, I just think it sounds great. I haven't had a chance to A-B it against my original yet, but I can already tell just from playing it through a tube amp and also playing it through a Peavey Bandit that it sounds fine. So for $60, you can't go wrong. I think it's really cool. So you probably all realize now, if you're on my Facebook page or you're a subscriber, that I recently live demoed a Squier Classic Vibe Telecaster, which is right here. And I've finally put new strings on this thing. And I've got to say, it plays so much better. The stock strings really didn't do it a lot of justice, but I got around it, and having played it again recently, I got to say, I'm really wrapped. And another thing too, like the Peavey Bandit amplifiers, far out. They're one of those amps that I've always thought were fantastic. Like, I've had two of them and they just sound good. You crank them up and they totally rock. And this is one of the new series ones. And, you know, I got a chance to use it a few times now. And the second time I didn't even bring my pedal. I just thought, you know what, the amp can do it all. Crank it up, use your volume control on your guitar, and you're absolutely set to go. And that's one of those great things about Peavey Bandits. They're plug and play. And that's kind of like a Supersonic by Fender. So I may reassess what I've got when I get back. Maybe make some adjustments to my collection. Not to say I'm gonna get a Bandit, but I'm gonna get another plug and play amp. I think that's definitely the way to go for me. And it makes me sort of play better when I'm not fiddling around too much. I'm not getting distracted by all the effects. It's great for me to have some effects on my sound. I really love some delay from time to time, and you know, a wah pedal, but just getting back to playing straight into an amplifier that sounds good is really, really fulfilling. And I think it's a testament to how, you know, a good combination with a guitar and amplifier can really work. And I kind of miss that, not having my Supersonic, but when I hurt my back, I had no choice. So I had a big Supersonic, not one of the 22s. But we may look at getting something like that down the track, because they just play themselves. So I'm definitely gonna stick to Fender amps. I don't think I'm gonna go into the boutique world for myself over the next year or two. I just really don't feel like there's gonna be a whole lot of extra tone for me playing a two rock anymore, as opposed to say playing a Fender amp. I can get a similar sound out of both when they're wide open. I mean, the two, they've all got their own voicing, and the voicing is what makes them unique, but I don't know, I just keep coming back to Fender amps, so I'm just not gonna bother anymore. I may even try a Marshall amp down the track. There's a particular amp that's supposed to be great for blues, and the name escapes me right now, but I'm gonna try and check that out as well and see how we go. I haven't been buying too much other stuff right now. It's been on the sort of down low this trip. I will though be buying hopefully another couple of pedals before I go. There's a couple of Electro-Harmonix ones that have come out that I'm really looking forward to testing, and they look and sound fantastic from what I can tell. So yeah, I'm totally blown away by this. And yeah, there's an East River Drive that I want to buy, as well as one that's called like a tube something. I've forgotten exactly what it's called. I saw it online last night and I went, wow, that would actually be really cool. I've also been lucky enough to receive a few pedals from all over the world, and one of which is the HotMod 800 Valve Distortion pedal. And this is basically like a Marshall in a box. It even has the funky little controls on it. And I can't wait to try this on a demo. I think it looks fantastic. It's made in Texas. It should be really, really cool. So I'm really looking forward to that. I've also received a few other pedals from the Donner company in China. I think there's a tuner, maybe an overdrive pedal and a chorus pedal from memory. I could be wrong. They're actually at my house waiting for me right now. So when I get back, I'll definitely be demoing some more pedals from those guys. The next pedal I was sent was called a King Bee Mark II. So yeah, I can't wait to try that out. From what I've heard online already, it's one of the best sounding overdrive pedals I've ever heard. So I'm dying to give this a go. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. I've also received a pedal or two from Dazatronyx, who are an Australian company who make really nice pedals. And they've been nice enough to send me some stuff out to demo as well. And I can't wait to try that. I think there's a fuzz and an overdrive pedal. And yeah, it's gonna be great. One of my friends picked up my mail on my behalf and yeah, he said some good things about them. So I can't wait to try them out. There's gonna be probably 30 guitar demos from Jerry's. And following that, there will probably be about maybe seven pedal demos somewhere around there. And yeah, it's gonna be cool. I've also got a couple of compilation videos of guitars as well as pedals, and a few lists that I've wanted to put together for quite some time. So it should be cool. There should be lots of good content going up. And if you have any suggestions, as per normal, let me know and I'll try to make it happen. So like I said, this video is a little bit different to my usual mailbag. I've had some requests to demo certain types of wah pedals from companies as well as all that kind of stuff. When I get home, I'm gonna head back to Deluxe Guitars and just pick up a bag full of pedals and start the ball rolling again. So there should be plenty. I've taken a lot of suggestions on board. I write a lot of stuff down, and when I get back, I'll definitely try to do it the best that I can. And yeah, I hope you're all enjoying the actual playing part at the start, you know, those backing tracks that I put together. It's actually from my new album. I just thought I'd cut them down a little bit and then make the demos a little different rather than just playing without music. I think sometimes it's good for these pedals to be, you know, backed with music, so you can see how they actually stand out when you kick them in. And that's, you know, that was an idea that Dr. Rick had, and it's a great idea. So thanks for that, Rick. As far as the Mustang Monday thing goes, I've had so many requests for, you know, artists that I can try to emulate their sound. I don't have a lot of the guitars that a lot of these guys would use, so I'm only going to be using a Strat, a Telecaster, my ES-335, as well as, you know, the whatever I've got, the Little Crow guitar. It won't matter. I'm just going to try and get it to sound the same, or as much as I can the same for me. So I'll read out some of the ones that I've got down on this list right now and show you what I've got. So right here, all the lists of the videos I'm going to make for tones over the next few weeks. And I might not be able to play like any of these guys or some of them, but I'm gonna try my best to at least get the tone from an album, a particular song, and have that as a reference so people can then check it out on Spotify or whatever, and then have a listen to the Mustang and see how it sounds. So I've got guys like John Mayer, BB King, Brad Paisley, The Edge, we're gonna try that one. Johnny Lang, Eric Clapton, Albert King, Tommy Castro, Dick Dale, which I can't play that style, but maybe I'll see if I can borrow Rick for a few of these. Albert Collins, Chris Isaac, Chris Kane, Buddy Guy, Hendrix, Knopfler, Stevie Ray, Jimmy Vaughan, the Deep Purple Tones, Freddie King, and Papa Chubby. So that's most of about 20 right there. So that'll keep me busy for a little while. I don't know if these will be released every week, because it actually takes quite a bit of time to get these done right. So it might be every other week. I'm not too sure yet, but I'll see how I go and see what the workload's like in getting videos up, because it, you know, as you may or may not know, it's kind of time consuming, but I really enjoy it. So I'm just gonna keep doing it when I get back. And yeah, I've just got a few other things I need to tie up, but I think this will start around the beginning of August, maybe the second weekend. I get back just before the start of August, so I'll have some time to, you know, at least try to get a few of these down. So what I'll definitely be doing is referencing a song or a live clip on YouTube or a studio clip, whatever, and then try and emulate that with whatever guitar I have. And guitars vary as well, so you may have to tweak them slightly, but the concept will be there, or at least a base for you to work with and tweak it to how you like. So that's about it for today. I know I haven't answered too many questions. It's just been a little bit of an explanation about what's been going on for me over the last 6 weeks. I got 2 more weeks to go and then I'm home. and my tan, or you know, whatever I've got going on right now, won't last when I get back, because it's gonna be cold. I'm not looking forward to that. I know that's kind of wimpy, but you know, I like the warm weather. How can you beat t-shirt and shorts every day? You just can't beat that. If you have any questions, definitely get back to me on this video as well as on Facebook, and I will absolutely reply on the next mailbag. It's just been really hard to monitor a lot of the comments while I'm traveling, so I just thought I'd show you what's been going on and what you can expect. And yeah, I hope to hear from you all soon. And things will be back to normal pretty soon. I'll have my usual backdrop going on, my lighting and all that kind of stuff. And it should be really, really cool to show everybody how many great left-hand electric guitars I've played in the last few weeks. It's really blown my mind. So if you're a lefty and you watch this channel, definitely share these videos around, because they're gonna be some of the best left-handed guitars that you just don't see anywhere. You know, if you're sick of just finding that one left-handed Mexican Tally, you can find a guitar, but that's all you find anywhere, then you're gonna love some of the stuff I've got coming up. So thanks so much for watching and for all the support. My Facebook has just clicked over 2,000 likes, and I appreciate everybody's feedback and help on that. It's always awesome to talk to people and to have people respond to stuff that I post and give me suggestions. I love it. So thanks again, and I'll speak to you all soon. See ya.